Today is my last day with David and Justin. Both have a great connection to nature abroad. And all week, I've wanted to show them how they can feel more connected to their home. So just 40 minutes away at the Cincinnati Nature Center, the best way to become more grounded is to get on the ground. We are at the Cincinnati Nature Center, about 20 miles outside of Cincinnati in this beautiful open wild space. And we are gonna be foraging for edible plants and fruits today.
One of the things we're gonna look for is Ohio's state native fruit.
I want to say buckeye, am I right?
Pawpaw.
Oh, pawpaw.
It is the state native fruit. Of course, that's our state tree, so that's very good. There?
I'm down for this. Like, send me out to the woods. Let me be in my natural habitat. This way, like, if I ever have to be out here, you know, the apocalypse happens, zombies come for me, or the world just ends, I'm prepared for it. You know, I'm down. I'm excited. Let's do this.
So, Jason, are we looking for things while we walk, or are we waiting to get to a destination?
We're gonna change how we view things, in fact, because, again, there's food everywhere. Above us, we have walnuts, which
we'll
get in a second. Normally, we get those when they fall off of the tree, but since they're low on available, we'll grab those. We're gonna try to not harm the tree if we can.
I'm trying.
I can get it with this.
Okay. And give them a little hook. They should pop right off right there.
Okay then.
That's convenient.
Oh yeah.
So that's meant as a defensive husk that's on there, and I'll show you how we open those up.
I'm happy to find what kind of things we can eat. I didn't realize there was so much natural food out there that you can just enjoy if you know what you're looking for.
Pawpaws, I actually have one here, and this is what we're after, in fact, since we're here. This long fruit, it does have an up and a down. We're attached to the tree kind of like that.
It's really fun to share this with Justin for the first time because we're finding, you know, even after 8 years, we're still finding new things about each other to get excited about, you know? So it's like being able to find things that interest us, and then it gives us more options besides on Sunday sitting on the couch and just playing Xbox all day. I think I shook too hard, but two came down.
Yep.
No, it's soft.
Okay.
Oh, yep, this is soft.
All right. Soft adjacent.
Soft adjacent?
Hiking to me is just marvelous, but when you add a mission, a goal, when you layer something in, like now you're foraging. We're hunters and gatherers at the end of the day. So when you're out there doing what your primal instincts were designed to do, it turns you into kind of a more connected to nature person.
Part of the garden here is an example for people because you can grow all these in your yard as well.
We don't get the opportunity to bond and just sit and enjoy and take in the space around us. And I think this is something that if we do on a regular basis, it will definitely build on us and be something that helps build our relationship and takes us even further.
What do we want to try first?
Ooh, pawpaw.
Pawpaw. If you've tried other tropical fruits that kind of have this look to them, those big black seeds inside look the same.
Okay. That's delicious.
It's buttery like an avocado, but much sweeter.
Custardy. It's like if an avocado mated with a papaya. So good.
It is really good.
Oh my God.
So here's your Jerusalem artichokes.
Oh, literally just grab a piece.
Yep. Eating them raw today.
Turnipy.
It is turnipy.
But sweeter.
It's what you dug up.
When I was a kid, we used to go morel mushroom hunting, you know, in the springtime, and we used to eat, my mom used to fry up dandelion greens.
Hold it on, keep your hands out of the way. Crank it down to get it tight until it cracks.
I know, I'm like, you'll shoot your eye out.
Yeah, you'll shoot your guy out, kid.
Yeah, I don't want to get you guys.
Exactly.
Play that again for you.
Justin and David have such a great dynamic between the two of them. They're fun, they're supportive, they're silly.
Do you want
to? We're like little squirrels.
We are.
I don't go out and hike as much as I want, but this is definitely something that encourages me to go do that more often.
We foraged for our own food.
That was amazing.
It was fantastic.
You liked it, huh?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so tell me about the experience. Did you even know most of these things that we ate were out here?
No. This is my first time hearing about most of this, except for the persimmons.
Huh. But did you even know those were native here?
No. That's what I'm saying. Either. Like, I've heard of persimmons. I've actually heard of pawpaws, but as far as them being in Ohio, no. And I mean, you know, I've heard of edible plants and things like that, but it's just like, you don't realize They're everywhere.
If you know what to look for.
If you know what to look for.
That's so much fun. Thank you, Kinga.
Thank you, guys. Yeah, you guys are so much fun.
Oh,
you guys did the digging.
Yeah, I mean, well, that was fun.
Yeah.
That was fun.